Hey guys, how's it going? It's Zed for me, and today we're going to be installing a rear storage shelf cover for the Tesla Model Y. This rear hatch cover is probably something that Tesla should have came out with as an OEM product, or you know, just included with the vehicle. Steve sent this cover as well as a couple other products that he has over to us to review and install in order for you guys to see what it's like. The main thing that I found really cool about his particular website is that you can't just add a product, add the customizations, add it to your cart, and then just pay and move on with your life. You actually have to email Steve and go through with him exactly what you want, which basically goes to show me that, you know, he's not really doing it just to mass produce these things and to really get it out there. He's doing it as almost a service to the people who actually want this kind of product. So when you buy this rear storage cover, Steve actually includes information and instructions on how to install everything. And it's here in black and white, but luckily you guys will have this video in order to see how to do it. Okay, so the installation is pretty easy. The first part is installing these large plastic hooks onto the headrest and the back seat. In order to do that, you raise the headrest a tiny bit, and then these plastic hooks allow the shelf to hang from it. Alternatively, you can tie the string directly to the rear seat headrest, but it makes it just a little bit more difficult to take the shelf off should you want to. In order to actually take the shelf off, if you just tie directly to it, you would need to take off the headrest, which requires a flathead screwdriver. At first, I liked the look of the plastic hooks, but then I thought about it. I rarely put the rear seats down, so I decided to just tie the strings directly onto the headrests for a cleaner look. Next, you install the rear support brackets by pulling back the trim a little bit. Apply the Velcro onto the brackets so that when you find the right position, you can stick it down so that it doesn't shift around. Without the Velcro on the bracket can shift when the car is moving, and then your shelf is going to fall when you hit a hard bump while you're driving around. This next part I did a little bit differently than the instructions. I just made a loop around the strut, and then the string hangs down for the shelf. The shelf comes with these small carabiners so that it can easily be removed if you want to remove the shelf. I completely omitted it as I didn't want to deal with metal on a carabiner coming into contact with the paint and potentially scratching it. Without it though, I need to take extra steps in order to take the shelf out. Alternatively, the shelf does come with these small cord clips which can insert into the trim on the hatch for easier removal. I think I'll use this method the next time I take the shelf out and have to reinstall it, because that's exactly what I was trying to do by avoiding the carabiner. The instructions say that it takes a couple of days for the strings to stretch out, and then to only double knot it afterwards, as well as cut it, singe it with a lighter to keep the strings from unraveling. I just tied a quick release loop onto the ends of mine for now. That way, if I want to remove the shelf, I can just pull on these knots and it'll quickly come off. The inconvenient part will be putting the strings back through the shelf, which takes some finagling. So the small cord clips are definitely going to be useful for this. Otherwise, that's basically pretty much it for the installation. It isn't too difficult. There is a little bit of trial and error to get the shelf height exactly how you want it and operational. You want it to sit completely level and also look like it was meant to be there. And so it takes a little bit of time in order to just find the right height. You could also flip the shelf if you want the black carpeted side to be on top, or you can order the shelf without any of the leatherette. But I do like the look of the white on top. From the interior looking back, it looks really nice with the white in my opinion. It'll probably also help keep the interior a little bit cooler in the summer. So there's actually two additional products that Steve sent over. I actually didn't know he was going to send these two things on top of the shelf itself. But the first one is a charge sleeve, and I'll show you what that is. So So this right here is the charge sleeve. It's basically a neoprene material cover that can go over your charger wiring and cabling and plug. And it basically keeps snow, ice, and other things off your actual charger. Now, I haven't personally made use of this yet, but I'll definitely keep it inside the vehicle. And then as you can actually see here, I already have a mat cover. This was something that I just bought off of Amazon. But Steve did send a carpeted trunk mat. And you know, from stock, these do not come with any sort of cover. And so if you don't want something like this, you might want to check out Steve's product, which is basically just a carpeted mat, which sits and exactly here. So that's basically it for today's video. I really want to thank Steve over at Voltshop for sending this out and for allowing us to take a look at it and to review it. I obviously really like this product. I really wish that Tesla had something like this OEM, but since they don't, I'm glad there are people out there like Steve who want to fill in those gaps and offer us really, really quality products for the Tesla. So if you guys have any questions or comments, please leave it below. Thank you guys for watching. Please consider subscribing if you're interested in more Tesla videos. Thank you guys. It's Ed for me, and I'll see you guys in the next one.
So this is actually something that I didn't catch when I took delivery of the vehicle. But as you can see, the trim piece in the upper panel on the right side is completely messed up. And essentially at the factory, whoever actually installed this panel decided to just mash it in, and one of the connectors was definitely smashed up. So I basically had to swap it out for a new one, and had to fix it on my own because I didn't want to wait 2 weeks for a service appointment. This is probably something that most manufacturers wouldn't have issues with in terms of quality control, but for Tesla, definitely something I wouldn't put past them at their current stages.